Hey guys, we are back again with another demo tutorial. Today we are going to be looking at Wotan, and what Wotan does is it automagically removes trends from time series data. So let's go ahead and click on the About button, and that's going to take us to this GitHub. And as we can see, there's already tutorials ready for us to use. So I'm also going to give you guys a little preview of what we have coming in store for y'all. In the near future, you will be able to access this GitHub through this Jupyter Notebook repository. You'll be able to click on the submitters, the person that, or the team who made these tutorials. You'll be able to click on their tutorials and open up whichever tutorial you want, and basically just use it like interactively. So taking that, I went ahead and I used that same tutorial and I added a few notes just to better understand this so that we can go through it together. So in this tutorial, we're going to be looking at the basic functionality of Wotan. So again, Wotan removes trends from time series data, and this is what that looks like. So first thing we are going to want to do is we're going to generate time series data with some noise added to it. So here, using NumPy, we go ahead and we set up our time and our flux array and our noise array. And then here, we just add that noise to our flux array. And then we're going to make sure to include a gap in our observation. And that's what this last line is doing down here. So let's go ahead and get started. So today we're gonna be using the flatten module, or the flatten part of Wotan. So what flatten does is it removes low frequency trends in time series data, as you can see here. And what it's going to return is it's going to return this flattened flux, which is your flattened flux, and it's going to return your trend flux, which is the trend in your flux. And what does that look like, right? So before we even show you what that looks like, all you're going to do is you're going to hit set some variable that will take in your flattened or detrended light curve, and another variable that will take your trend in that light curve. So flatten LC, trend LC is equal to flatten, time, flux, window length, and return trend. And later on we'll be going over what this window length means. So let's go ahead and plot the results using Matplotlib. We go ahead and we plot this light curve. So in the scatter plot, this is our pseudo data that we created up above, and then the red line is the trend line. And as you can see, it fits really, really well. And there's a reason for that. And again, we'll touch on that later. So pretty simple so far. Very, very useful. Now going down, we're going to look at the detrended light curve. So typically, you would have to divide your raw flux by this red trend line to get your detrended light curve. But as we said before, this flatten LC will do that for us. So we're just gonna go ahead and scatter plot our time and our flattened LC. This is our detrended light curve. Looks pretty detrended to me, or flattened, if you will. So now back to the window length question. So what is window length? Window length is the length of the filter. And using flatten, we can set window length to a couple different values to see which one yields the best trend. So we go ahead and set up some variables, and we set up window length to be 0.2, 0.5, and 1, and we want to see which one fits best with our data. So we go ahead and we plot, we give them labels, we give them names. Now let's see what we got here. So we have these three trend lines. We have the blue corresponding to a window length of 0.2, the red to a window length of 0.5, and the orange to a window length of 1. So as you can see here, the blue one looks like it's already starting to lose its fit. So this one's probably an overfit. The orange one doesn't do too well at the very beginning of the plot, so we're going to say that that one is an underfit. And it looks like the red line fits just right. So playing with the window lengths helped us determine a better trend for our data. But there is this weird data going on over here that doesn't really conform to everything else. So we ask ourselves, do we want to keep that? So going down, we can go to this removing edges part of the tutorial. So this edge cutoff, what this is saying is at 0.5 days, we want you to cut off all that data because it's near the edge and it's not as robust as the rest of it. Now, the window length is also set to 0.5, and the edge cutoff can do a maximum of the window length divided by 2. So when we plot this, here we have the blue line is no edges removed, and it goes on all the way here because it is essentially the same line. And then this red line is the edges removed. So here is the trend underscore LC2. Over here we have trend underscore LC2, label edges removed. So our edge cutoff is set to 0.5. We go down here, that should be here, but it actually cuts off at 0.25 because again, the maximum it allows is for a window length divided by 2. And they provide a great explanation for that down here. So now basically what we did was we made this trend more accurate. So what happens when there's a giant gap in our data? Like up above here, there's a giant gap between 6 and 8 days, but our detrending method still works really well. That happens because when there's a gap, Wotan will treat the data as individual sub-light curves, and it will go from there. So what that means is, as we can see down here, in the handling gaps portion of this tutorial, also near the end of this tutorial, we are going to play with the break tolerance argument within flatten. So as I was describing before, your data is going to be split into individual sublight curves if there's gaps in the data, and this is done automatically because your break tolerance argument will be set to 1 by default. You can disable that by setting your break tolerance to 0. And what that does is instead of treating your light curve as individual subplots, it will treat it all as one. And let me show you all what that means. So again, we generate some time series data with some noise, just like we did up above. We're going to use dot flatten to see the difference in break tolerance values. So we are going to set one line equal to this break tolerance of 0.1. That will be our blue line down here, trend LC1, trend LC1. Trend LC2 will be a break tolerance of 0. So this disables our break tolerance. So again, this will make it so that the whole thing is treated as one data set. And this will correspond to our red line right here. It's trend LC2, trend LC2. So now let's see what it looks like. So as we can see, the red line where the break tolerance is disabled, in the gap, it stops fitting the data because it treated it all as one. So it's trying to, you know, as you can see here, it almost looks like it's trying to connect, right? But when the blue one with the break tolerance of 0.1, with the break tolerance not disabled, you have this really, really nice trend line because again, it's treating the data as individual subplots. So that is Wotan. If you guys have any questions, feel free to comment below, or you guys can follow us on Twitter at exoplanetmodels. And thank you. Have a great day.